Welcome. My name is Jacob Britt, and I will be your host for this episode of Voices of Creativity Online. Today, we have with us writer and publisher, Dr. Ronald Coleman. Can you please tell us about yourself and the work that you do?
My work in general is I have a PhD in regenerative medicine, and I work at building cellular systems to help treat and make new medicines for diseases. But in my other life, I write comic books and short stories and all kinds of things. I just am a writer, I suppose you would say. My main project is one called Kevin the Drunk Jedi. That's the one that I do the most with. And I've written 2.5 books and then written a bunch of 6-panel stories and 3-panel stories and little mini vignettes.
As a cell biologist, what does your work entail?
Well, I've worked in a number of different areas of cell biology. Where I got my PhD was primarily in multiple sclerosis medicine, but I've also worked with a Parkinson's group, and I even worked at the San Diego Wild Animal Park, making rhinoceros stem cells from rhino skin so that we can try and save the northern white rhino. So that's kind of I've worked all kinds of places. Right now, what I work on is developing primary cells for researchers. So I take primary tissue and separate it to its constituent cell types. It's fun that I'm getting to isolate the cells and work on new techniques to make them more pure and have healthier cells. And that's really important for things like, right now we do a lot of stuff with lung cells, which is very important for researchers who are studying COVID, that they need primary healthy lung cells that they can see how do these medicines that are developing affect them.
Can you tell us why creativity is so important in the work that you do?
Absolutely. I've worked in a lot of industries. I worked in the film industry. I've worked other places, and people are sometimes kind of fascinated. They're like, well, you're a scientist and in a grip. And I think that both of them rely on problem solving. And really what science is structured creativity. It's being creative, but having a set of rules that you follow and methods for making your creativity more efficient. So I think for me, I'm a very creative person, both in the lab and out. But sometimes, you know, the grind of lab work requires you to have some more creative output. So that's why I enjoy the comic books and other things like that. It just kind of gives me an ability to tell stories that are, you know, it's so important to have truth in the lab. It's fun to get to tell stories that are not true in a comic book.
How's the rhino cells, like saving the white rhinos, right? How's that going?
Yeah, so pretty well. So I was brought in to kind of, because I have experience with growing rhino stem cells, which is a weird thing to have experience with. But they brought me in, and what we're doing is we've taken the skin from rhinos, actually that are dead. These rhinos are gone, and they're going to we've made stem cells from their skin. Then we're going to make sperm and eggs from them, from the stem cells, and then do IVF. And we have southern white rhinos that are going to act as surrogates. So we will make genetically completely northern white rhinos, which there are, I think, 3 of in the world at this point. But they will be birthed from southern white rhinos. And then eventually, you know, they'll have them breed together. So I get to have updates on it, but I'm not getting to directly work on it anymore. But that, I'm going to be really happy when that finally comes to fruition, when that first northern white rhino is born at the Wild Animal Park. It'll be pretty special.
How do you combine creativity with your science side? How do those play with each other?
Well, I've actually received quite a few opportunities to do that. It started with, I was just randomly called by someone who saw I was wearing a geeky t-shirt on my lab picture. And so she called me, and she was from the Fleet Science Center. And they were trying to put a panel together with scientists and comic book writers to see, you know, how much of science influences comics and how much do comics influence science. And I got to be on a panel with Kevin Eastman, who's the co-creator of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. And that was amazing. We were actually, you know, still friends to this day. We have a project that we're working on together, which is really cool. It's not near ready, but he's a very, very busy guy. But he's been very generous with his time, and it's been awesome to have a guy like that as a friend. It's really cool. I've also worked with author Jonathan Mayberry, who does, he did the V-War series recently, and he's got a lot of different stories. And I've on two different, on a comic book of his and on a novel of his, I've gotten to be the science behind the thing where he said, I want, how could a evil super genius make a super soldier? And so I got to devise this whole system that someone could use to implant into soldiers. Also, he had a story called Pandemica, which there's a Dr. Ronald Cole who is, you know, looks exactly like me. He took pictures of me and drew me into the comic. So it's been fun. And like I said, that's been an area where I got to blend storytelling and science really directly.
What do you think inspired you to write Kevin the Drunk Jedi?
Well, what happened was I was sitting at a restaurant with a palm tree up front, and I thought, it would be bad to put a lightsaber into that tree. They have different vein structures in palm trees and other trees. I don't want to get into that. That's really weird stuff, monocots versus dicots. But anyway, so I was thinking, man, that's like the kind of thing a drunk Jedi would do. And then I thought about, well, if you were a drunk Jedi, what would you need? And I thought about putting a breathalyzer on the lightsaber so like they couldn't turn it on if they were too drunk. Anyway, I was talking to this guy, Douglas, at Comic-Con about it, and he said, oh, that sounds funny. I should draw that. And so we just kind of got together. We made a poster that we sold for a few years. And then people were saying, like, well, where's the comic book? You know, you just have a poster right now. Where's the book? And so finally, I learned how to write comic, because writing comic books is different than writing short stories or other things. It's a really different process. So I kind of learned in the first one, and that took actually a couple of years. And then the second one happened in a few weeks after we released the first one. And the third one is, I'm almost done. And then we'll start on production of that.
Do you have any other upcoming projects?
I have a couple of short stories that I'm shopping right now. My favorite one is called Death Phone, coming soon to some short story anthology near you. And it's kind of a fun, interesting one. That's where I've been playing the most lately. But mostly it's just you submit short stories and hear nothing from them. So that's mostly what I've been doing with my other writing, is I just getting ignored by publishers. Just, you know, a hobby. Everyone's got to have one.
All right. That's great. We would like to thank you for your time and being on Voices of Creativity.
No problem. It's my pleasure.